An interesting question came up this past week in our private mastermind community. Somebody asked, how can I keep track of how many times someone has edited a record inside of my Airtable base? So in this video, I want to show you exactly how you can solve this with a simple automation that's going to update with a count every single time somebody performs an edit. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we help you save 20 hours of your time every week with no-code tools. If that's of interest and you want to learn exactly how you can start leveraging no-code, the best place to start is to learn how to build automations that will perform your mundane, repetitive tasks automatically for you in the background. Any kind of copy-paste function that you do on a daily basis, almost guaranteed, can be automated. So if that's of interest, check out my training where I'm going to teach you the fundamental building blocks. You can get that training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. And it's really appropriate that we talk about that beforehand because in this very video, I'm going to be showcasing an automation. So if you haven't got those fundamentals in place yet, definitely want to start there. But let's hop into this actual topic. In my screen here, you see that I've got three different field types. I have a name, which is just text field here, and I've got a couple of different test names. I have a stage, which can be one of three different options here, and I have an email field as well. Now, presumably, any of these fields can be edited. The name, the stage, and the email can all be edited by users who access my database. So how can I keep a counter? Well, sure, I can build a number here, and let's call it the counter, and make this a number field, and I can just set it to be an integer. So far, so good. But if somebody on my team comes in and moves this to stage two, then they would need to add a one here and say, I made an edit. And then if someone later came by and changed this to stage three, then they would have to manually count this up one and make this a two. Nobody wants to do that. Doing things manually is not the no-code way. So how can we leverage automation to tackle this for us? It's actually a pretty simple and straightforward automation, so let's hop on into it. First things first, we need to present ourselves with the next increment of the counter. And this is easy to do with a simple formula. I'm just gonna call this field plus one, and I'm gonna write a formula here in my next field, and I'm gonna take whatever that counter number is, take that number, in this case it's two, in this case it's blank or zero, and I just wanna add one to this. No big deal here. Let's create this field. And exactly as you would expect, 2 plus 1 is 3, and then down here we have no number at all, so of course the next counter, the plus 1, is 1, right? So no matter what number we have here, if it's 16, whatever, this number, after you give it a minute to think, is always going to be one integer greater than that number. Now the next part of this is to actually watch these records for edits. And this is where you can get creative. It depends on what particular places you want to watch. You might say, in our example, I want to know if anybody makes an edit to any three of these fields, name, stage, or email. Or you could say, I only care if somebody edits the email or the stage. Whatever you want to do, totally plausible. Let's go ahead and pop open our automation panel inside of Airtable in the upper right corner. And we're going to create a custom automation. Now, when we go to watch to see if any changes have been made, we're going to use the when a record is updated trigger type here. By making this selection on the right-hand side now of my panel, I have to choose a table. In this case, I only have the one table, so nothing too fancy there. You can optionally choose a view, you don't have to, and then I need to also tell it what fields to watch. And this is where we need to bring in those fields that we care about being edited. In our case, we're going to look at all three of those different editable fields, the name, the stage, and the email. Now, quick pause here. You cannot include your counter here. If you include your counter inside of the watch, well, this counter is what we're going to be updating. So if you accidentally include this in your trigger, your automation is going to perform a perpetual loop. It will update the counter, and then it will update the counter again and again and again. So whatever you do, make sure that you don't toggle on your counter field, which is your number field, where you're watching the number of edits that you've made. Make sure that that's toggled off, but whatever other fields you want to watch here that you care about edits, those must be toggled on. Now from here, we can go ahead and choose a record to move forward in our automation. Let's take test number two here. Now on the next step, we're going to build the action. So we need to update the record that triggered the automation. This is pretty straightforward as well. Here we're going to select a table. Yeah, we've already done that. It's only the one table. What record are we updating? Well, that's the record that triggered the automation. Make sure to use the record ID here. So the first step in the automation is where we found this record. We're going to expand that. And the very first piece of information here is the Airtable record ID of the record that triggered the automation. And we need to plug that in here. Now, what fields do you want to update? Well, the field that we want to make a change to, or we want to increase by one, is the counter. Remember that this already has a number, even if it's blank or zero, and we need to increment it by one. So that's the field that we need to make an update to. So I bring in counter. What are we updating it to? This is pretty simple, and this is why we built that plus one formula field. Click on the gear icon here and change over to dynamic variables. We want to use variables from another step in the automation. Namely, if we select dynamic here, we can now hit that plus button, expand the first record that started our automation, scroll on down here, and here is our plus one. So you see that our counter at the time that the automation triggered had a value of 16. And our formula knows that 1 more than 16 is 17. So what we need to do is actually replace the 16 in our counter with the formula field. So we're going to insert the plus 1 formula here. Super simple automation here, but the power of this is going to be quite profound. So we can now generate a preview, and we will see that yes, we would be changing the counter from 16 to 17. Now we can do that, actually run the automation as configured if we want. We can click run test, and you'll see that yes, these are the things that changed. Of course, the counter is incremented by one. It went from 16 to 17. The other important part is that our plus one formula is now incremented by one more, so that the next time the automation runs, the counter will be 17, the plus one calculation will be 18, and we're gonna take the 18, plug it into the counter, and you see how this continues into perpetuity. So let's go ahead and turn our automation on, give it a name if you haven't already, but let's take this out for a spin and test it. So I want to make a change here to my stage. I change it to stage 2. Give it just a second to wait, and we should see that the automation will pick that up, and there it goes, plugs in the number, the proper counter, and our new increment has gone up. What if I want to make a change here? I don't like test 3, I want to call it test 4. Cool, I make that edit. Airtable Automation on the back end is going to think just a little bit for us, and once it realizes that I edited that record, as you see right there, counter's gone up. So again, you can target whatever fields you want to in your database. In this case, I did the name, the stage, and the email, but I could just watch the stage, I could just watch the email, or I could watch all of them. But whatever you do, make sure you don't include that counter in there. Otherwise, like I said, this thing's gonna just keep ticking up into perpetuity. I hope you got a ton of value from this and it helps you keep track of how many edits are going on inside your database. If you want to stay on top of no code and utilizing automation to run a more efficient business, be sure to subscribe to this channel and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.